how far we've come, my baby. We might have took the long way. We knew we'd get there someday. They said, I bet they'll never make it. But just look at us holding on. We're still together, still going strong.
Together into this place which has been sanctioned according to law for the celebration of marriages to witness the joining matrimony of Molly and Thomas. Could I have the bride's full name, please?
Molly Louise.
The groom's full name, please.
Thomas James Randall.
Molly and Thomas, before you join in matrimony, I have to remind you of the solemn and binding character of the vows you are about to make to each other. Marriage, according to the law of this country, means the union of two people voluntarily entered into life to the exclusion of all others. Molly Louise Hope and Thomas James Ramsbottom now intend to enter such a marriage. Any person knows of any lawful impediments or has not been joined in matrimony, you should now declare it. Can't get a figure at that point. At this point, could I ask the bride's father, Duane, to please stand? And I ask, who gives this woman to be married to this man?
I do.
Do you give your consent and approval to this marriage?
Yes.
Perhaps not so cheerfully. You may be seated. The purpose of marriage is that you may always have love, care for, and support each other through all the joys and sorrows of life. And this love may be fulfilled in a relationship of permanence and continuing commitment. We trust these hopes come true for you both. Molly and Thomas wish to marry, for in each other's company they found fulfilment and love. As a consequence of this, they've drawn closer to each other and now wish to publicly affirm their relationship and to offer each other the security that comes from legally binding vows, sincerely made and faithfully kept. You are here to witness this occasion and to share in the joy which is theirs. I want you to ask them both in turn to declare you do not know of any lawful reason why should not be married to each other. Would you care to face each other and join hands, please? Thomas, would you repeat the marriage declaration after me, please? I declare
that I know
of no legal reason why I, Thomas James Ramsbottom, may not be joined
in matrimony
to Molly Louise Hope. And Molly, would you repeat the marriage declaration after me, please? I declare
that I know
of no legal reason why I, Molly Louise Hope,
may not be joined
in marriage. I forgot you getting married to.
To Thomas James Ramsbottom.
To maintain a happy marriage, you will both need to be loving, patient and understanding. And in such love lies the hope of a successful marriage. Marriage is a desire by two people to share themselves and their experiences with each other and a willingness to accept each other for what they are. So on that basis, I ask you, Thomas, do you take Molly to be your lawful wedded wife? Will you love, honour and cherish her?
I do.
And I ask you, Molly, do you take Thomas to be your lawful wedded husband? Will you love, honour and cherish him?
I will.
You are both of them declare your freedom to marry and your intention to marry each other. I'm now going to ask you both to make the declarations that will unite you in marriage. So ladies and gentlemen, for the exchange of the vows, could I ask you to stand, please? Thomas, will you repeat after me, please? I call upon
These persons here present. To witness.
That I, Thomas James Ramsbottom. Take thee, Molly Louise Hope.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
And Molly, would you repeat after me, please? When we finish giggling, can we? I call upon.
These persons here present.
To witness.
Take thee, Thomas James Ramsbottom.
To be my lawful wedded husband. Would everybody please be seated except Sophie, please? And at this moment, could I call upon Sophie for a reading, please?
Now you feel no rain, for each of you will be sheltered for the other. Now you feel no cold, for each of you will be warmth to the other. Now there will be no loneliness, for each of you will be companion to the other. Now you are two persons, but there is only one life before you. May beauty surround you, both in the journey ahead and through the years. May happiness be your companion, and your days together be long and upon the earth.
Bridal party, please stand. Yes, we've worked this out now.
Thank goodness.
We have now come to giving and receiving the wedding rings. The wedding ring is an unbroken circle. It has no beginning, it has no end. It symbolises unending and everlasting love and is the outward sign of the lifelong promises you both just made to each other. Could I ask Mr. Pearson to join us, please? Could we start first with Molly's ring? Would you pass that to Thomas, please?
I have no idea which is which here. No.
Could you take the ring out of the box, please? It helps when it's looking out the finger. Could you take the ring and place it on the third finger, please, of Molly's left hand? All the way on, please. And holding hands and looking at Molly, would you say after me, please? I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a token.
As a token.
Of my love and affection.
Of my love and affection.
And a symbol.
And a symbol.
Of all we share. Of all we share.
Of all we share.
Wear it with love.
Wear it with love.
This day.
This day.
And every day.
And every day.
Molly, would you respond, please? I accept this ring.
I accept this ring.
And I'll wear it with love.
And I'll wear it with love.
This day.
This day.
And every day.
And every day.
Thomas, can we have the ring, please? Would you pass that to Molly? Take that ring, place that on the third finger of Thomas' left hand. Holding hands and looking at Thomas, would you say after me, please? I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a token.
As a token.
Of my love and affection.
Of my love and affection.
And a symbol.
And a symbol.
Of all we share.
Of all we share.
Wear it with love.
Wear it with love.
This day.
This day.
And every day.
And every day.
Thomas, would you respond, please? I accept this ring.
I accept this ring.
And I'll wear it with love.
And I'll wear it with love.
This day.
This day.
And every day.
And every day.
Molly and Thomas, when you look at those rings in the future, may they always remind you of how happy you are today, and which you love each other, and of all the many good reasons that made you choose each other as partners for life. In the presence of your family and friends, you've consented to be joined in matrimony. Let us hope today will form a milestone to look back upon with much love and happiness. You symbolise your marriage by the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of the wedding rings. It is my great pleasure to declare that you are now husband and wife. You may kiss your bride.
You're the cure, you're the pain, you're the only thing I wanna touch. Never knew that it could mean so much, so much. You're the fear, I don't care, cause I've never been so high. Follow me through the dark, let me take you past the satellite. You can see the world you brought to life, to life. So love me like you do, la la, love me like you do.
I give you Mr. and Mrs. Ramsbottom.
Love me like you do, la la.
everyone to be upstanding and give a massive round of applause to the new Mr. and Mrs. Ramsbottom. Let's have a massive round of applause for Father McBride. Dwayne is going to start the speeches.
Good afternoon. How are we doing? A massive thank you to everybody that's turned up today, especially me mum and dad. Stand up, mum and dad. Come in. I'm lucky enough to bring up my Molly. And I owe a great deal of gratitude. Thank you very much for everything you've done for my mum and Catherine. I've got to make one of the bridesmaids. One of the bridesmaids, show me your hands. Stand up, you get girls, come on. Don't they look beautiful? They've done a great job today. When I first met Tommy... When I first met Tommy, I didn't know what to expect. All I was told by my older child, my oldest child, that he was a doorman. A big guy from Manchester and a bit older. You know, what I was expecting was Peter Kay. Well, we didn't. We got Tommy. And he's a great lad. And yes. Billy, where are you, Billy? There he is. Bill, stand up. Stand up, Bill, up again.
Hey, oh, Billy. Yes. Yeah, 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 yeah. Not the other Bill.
She's always skinny. You know, she owes everybody money. Please help yourself. It's in the post box. There's probably a few things in there. Molly, I'm very, very proud of you. You're beautiful today. In fact, you're beautiful every day. And come in. I love you very much. So that only leaves me to say, can everybody raise their glasses and toast the beautiful couple, Molly and her Tommy. To Molly and her Tommy. Yay! Yay!
Ladies and gentlemen, let's have a massive round of applause, please, for your groom.
It's a menu.
It is. Spicy sausage times two. We're all this morning, so that's a bear with me. last week, I mean. First of all, we would like to thank my brand new father-in-law, Dwayne, for his kind words and best wishes. Thank you very much, Dwayne. Yeah. I think it's worth a mention that there might be a few more toasts throughout the next few moments. Is my speech and a couple of others And that makes it a few more speeches. Wow. I was definitely Great. Still drunk at this point. So make sure your glasses are topped up and a nice little reminder for table four that this is a marathon, not a race, okay?
Table four. Yeah.
I picked from the list.
Yes, Holly.
Make sure you take little sips, not large gulps. So now that's done, I would like to welcome all of our guests on behalf of myself and my new wife. Hey. Hey. The length and breadth of the country from up by Scotland and right down to Guildford and beyond. So thank you for making your efforts and getting here today. Thank you very much.
And Scotland,
Now for the compliments starting off with my beautiful bride Molly, who I think you all agree looks absolutely stunning this evening.
Not as stunning as you, Tom.
No, I'd like to thank all the beautiful bridesmaids for their overwhelming support that they have shown Molly over the last few months. So thank you very much to all the bridesmaids. I'd like to thank my dad and his wife Tracy for their support over the last few months as well. Also Molly's dad and my father-in-law once again, Dwayne, and Molly's nan and granddad, Leslie and Roger, for their support. Jake, should I say. He is Roger, even. I didn't get it wrong, Molly. For their support. I'd like to hand over now to me, both of me. Am I sure?
Yeah.
Why?
Yeah.
Sure.
Let's
speeches. Oh no, I'm not sure about that. I don't want to, but I've got to. I'd like to hand over to my two best men, Tom and Aidan. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening.
Thank you all for coming. I'll start here. I read somewhere that a best man speech shouldn't take any longer. It takes the groom to make love. So, should cut it there, really.
See ya.
I could make it as long as it takes a game of Monopoly with these two, which lasts for days. Absolute joke. So I think we'll keep it somewhere in the middle. But first, I've got a gift for both of you. A private gift.
Oh no.
They'll get it.
Oh no.
I'll let them explain later if they'd like to.
We don't want to.
No, I didn't think so.
We'll leave that right.
I'd like to thank Tommy and Molly for making me their southern best man.
What was Molly's?
And Tommy, can I say, well, you always look beautiful for today. There's something special about that, mate. Thank you very much. Molly, you look exceptional today. Absolutely stunning.
Thank you.
Bridesmaids, beautiful. Groomsmen, especially myself. I'd say we did a good job. I'd also like to thank the wedding party and everyone for joining us tonight. I'm just going to hand over to Tommy's gravy and his chips. Mr. Pearson.
I bet you now he's a few nervous people in here. I bet you now.
I've actually wrote this, and this is the honest truth. I'm sure for this part of this speech, I have a few people nervous. But nobody more than Molly, who's probably got a knife strapped into that table with you. So, I'm going to keep it nice and actually be honest. So I hope you all remember that as well. Tommy and Tommy were met in high school. Didn't like him. Thought he was an idiot. Turns out, with that alike, him and several long lost brothers. We did everything together. We dived in mud on special occasions like parents' evening. Most important night of the year, we sat there drinking, painting art.
as you do. We also developed this game over the years where we had this competition in science where it was the first one to get sent out. We hold the record of 4 seconds. So as you can imagine, we're not scientists. So we've got a lot in common, both slim, funny, talented. Sorry, I've got thinking. I've got bullet points, but I really can't because I just want to be honest. And we grew up together, he was my best pal. I hate him as much as I love him because we're so alike. I weren't going to talk about you, but I really can't help it. Molly here, to me, when Tommy moved away and came back, he was a different person. He went away with my best pal, my drinking buddy, my alcoholic mate, which did daft stuff. But he came back as the ideal man for Molly. I seen a guy which fell in love instantly, and I thought, you know what? I fucking hate him. On my own now. So there I was, drinking on my own, crying. You know what I should do? So we grew up together anyway. Before we left, we went on a few holidays together. Bit of daft stuff. Billy over there took us away to Bummins in November. Freezing cold. Sarah was there as well. So me and Tommy, as you do, decided, you know what? Let's get this outdoor pool in November. So we jumped in. We got caught by security, so we started legging it. Paul was always, so that's what made him in. We're like, hello? Okay. Bear in mind, right, we've got a massive trail of water falling us. By the way, you only prefer a pair of chains that you left in the pool. All in all, I hated him growing up. And then he went and met this guy, so I'm going to pass it back over now before I finish and destroy him completely. So I'll let him be the nice one now.
Nice job!
Now Tommy, he found life hard down south at first. He couldn't quite understand the lingo we used. Like the time the shopkeeper called him a geezer. And then he couldn't understand why the woman in Greg's couldn't give him a meat and potato pie. They just don't exist. On both occasions, someone nearly got hurt, that's all I'm going to say. But Molly is the saviour. She made him feel right at home. She eased him into life down south and helped him break them language barriers. Molly, she was a regular down in Flares, where these two met and kindled their love. Tommy's working on the door there. Same working. Right. And that's where their love came from. Tommy kept her a secret for a little while, and I think that was for her safety. Before she realised that Tommy and I could be her worst nightmare when we were together. But Molly, you're definitely safe for this one. Still remember the day Tommy met your granddad and your dad. I had a phone call within minutes of getting home, saying I definitely don't want to piss them two off. They are big fuckers, is what he said. He said that I will be buried alive. So on that note, I'm going to pass back to Tom. I'm just going to say anything nice now. So, there's a bit of an ending to this, really, and I'm not a softie, but this person was... He's not here, she's not here anymore, it's Tommy's mum. I'm going to tell you a bit about Tommy's mum, right? We're all clapping and stuff now, and you're all probably going to hear her, but she was the most funniest, craziest person I have ever met. First time I ever met her, properly, I went to where she lived with Tommy. We played on the PlayStation, and she tried dyeing her hair.
Oh no!
She tried to dye it red. So she dyed in this colour. For a fucking man. So he came out pink. So there we was in the living room. I'm not fucking finished yet. So there we was in the living room. We can hear music playing. This door burst open. Rod Stewart, do you think he's sexy? So you can imagine, if you want my butt. Wait a minute, we didn't see this. All we seen was this. Then Tyrone went, hiya boys! I was scarred for life. Tommy, you wouldn't make a proud today, mate. Molly,
can you dance here?
On a serious note, when Molly first came up in my opinion, she struggled. She was trying to get her fucking rams born. Anybody that can tame a rams born, in my opinion, deserves a toast. So raise a glass to taming a rams born.
I don't like that toast.
To be honest, mate, you left me and now on my own. Thanks. Your mum would be so proud of you today, as if everybody is in this room. Molly? Good fucking mum.
Just going to finish up.
Enjoy
the rest of the night. What I'm going to say is, you two are the greatest at this couple right now. I'm glad to say you two are a strong part of my life. Tommy, better make the most of this one, because you'll be lost without her. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to raise your glass and wish the best of the future to Mr. and Mrs. Ramsbottom.
Yay! That's it.
Thank you.
Yeah. like to join them on the dance floor? I think we need some more romance going on. Come on.
Look in your eyes, I see a memory.
could only happen at a Ramsbottom wedding, to be honest.
Sweep you off of your feet. Will your mouth still remember the taste of my love? Will your eyes still smile from your cheeks? Darling, I will be loving you till we're 70. And baby, my heart could still fall as hard at 23. And I'm thinking about how people fall in love in mysterious ways. Maybe just the touch of a hand. Well, me, I fall in love with you every single day. And I just want tell you I am. So honey, now take me into your loving arms. Kiss me under the light of a thousand stars. Place your head on my beating heart. I'm thinking now my hair's all but gone and my memory fades, and the crowds don't remember my name. When my hands don't play the strings the same way, I know you will still love me the same. 'Cause honey, your soul could never grow. Baby, your smile's forever in my mind and memory. I'm thinking about how people fall in love in mysterious ways. And maybe it's all part of a plan. kiss me under the light of a thousand stars. Oh, darling, place your head on my beating heart. I'm thinking out loud that maybe we found love right where we are. Or maybe we found love right where we are. And we found love right where we are.
There he is,
we've got him.
I'm in.
Are you ready, Thomas James Ramsbottom?
This one goes out to Mary Howard.
Hello, Molly, Tommy. This is your dad.
And father-in-law.
And father-in-law. It's been a lovely day, and I'm really proud of the pair of you. Tommy, you're a top lad, and I know you will take real care of my little girl. My job now is to make sure you do that. And love to the pair of you. And I know Catherine has something she would like to say.
I just want to say thank you for making me your maid of honour. Had the best day, and I love you both lots.
Is that it?
Yeah.
That's it. Absolute rubbish from my oldest daughter.
I love you.
We love you, Molly. You're
Bye.
The greatest. Bye.
Bye.
Hi, Tommy and Molly. Thanks for letting us be such a significant part of your day. I absolutely adore Tommy. I was with him the day he was born, and I'm so pleased that he's chosen somebody as beautiful as Molly to share the rest of his life with. Think the world of you, Tom.
Thanks, Tommy and Molly, for inviting me down from Scotland. It's been an amazing day. I love you both so much, and I'll never forget that you stole my white Power Rangers costume.
Power Rangers.
Hi, congratulations to you both. We love you both to bits, don't we?
More than your life will ever know.
Yeah. We're still...
Can I just say, Tommy, you've been a pleasure to have as my son, my youngest son. And I tell you what, you are a star. We love Molly so much. She's been
beautiful. You're a
absolutely beautiful in our family. And she always will be. And we wish you the best of life.
Molly, me and you, love.
Get in there.
Hi, Molly, Tommy. Hope you had a lovely time since you got married. I hope you enjoy this little message. We don't want you to have any little ram's bottoms for a while because you haven't got your own house yet.
And we can't afford it.
And we can't afford the deposit. No,
we've given you everything anyway.
Yeah, we can't give you no more. So, that's wrong.
Anyway,
that's
Tommy,
wrong.
Tommy, no more. You've got your lucky man there. She means the world to me, my Molly. When she first came to us, when she was five, she was four.
but she'd go to batting. When she was four, she was a little timid little girl, and she grew up to be a most beautiful girl. She was loving, spiteful at times. She used to pull other children's hairs and kick people, but that
we
was
used
just...
to call you the Chucky doll.
Yeah, the Chucky doll. She was a little Chucky doll. We took her to Florida. We took her all over the world. She's been everywhere. And once she was in Florida, and she said, "Granddad, come and help me." She was on a rope ladder, well up in the trees. I had to climb all up this rope ladder, all across the top, to get her.
Down a big slide.
Down a big slide with her, to get her back down to the ground.
You couldn't stand up, could you, when you got to the ground?
No, that couldn't be. But she's been a...
delight.
She has been a delight. She's kept us young. She kept me poor. Then Tommy comes along.
He's kept us even poorer.
No, Tommy's all right.
No, he's a nice
Tommy,
boy.
Tommy, when I first met Tommy at a barbecue, he was a big lad.
And,
big lad he was, and I'll give him an arm wrestle. And this arm wrestle, I, being an old man, he thought he was a strong lad, and I thought I was a weak old man, but I beat him, and he's always had respect for me after that, and he's just a nice, and he looks after Molly, that's the main thing. I mean, what else can I say? They're a good couple. And, well, that's it.
Yeah.
Really, and...
We love you very much.
We love you both very much indeed. I hope you have many, many years of each other.
Right, you're probably thinking, shit, it's us two.
Yeah.
Absolute great day. I'm enjoying myself. He's not. I'm the better best man, by the way.
Of course.
Thank you very much for inviting us. We both wish you the best luck as best men together. I'm the better looking one. Aidan?
That's it. Thanks for today. Appreciate everything. You know, we've worked hard to get here today, and yeah, without us you'd be knackered,
because we're
we are beautiful
gift.
And we are God's gift, but at the end of the day it's your day, your special day, and we love you.
Tiddly winky winky winky, winky tiddly winky woo.
That's it.
Tommy, just seeing you right here today has proper amazed me. I'm not even kidding. From like going back when we was in school, when we used to go back to my house, get on the trampolines, get the boxing gloves on, and smash the hell out of each other. And now seeing you here, getting married, is absolutely out of this world. You have like inspired me to grow up as a man myself, and I respect you for that, Tommy. And I always will do. And I wish you and Molly the best to come. So, yeah, that's me done.
Well, Tommy, from the moment you come and work for me, down in Guildford, and you first clapped eyes on Molly. To see this day come is actually quite a quite impressive thing. So pleased for the best, both of you, and I wish you all the best for the future. I know you'll be so happy together. Absolutely useless, the pair of you, but still, all the best for the both of you, and I'm sure you'll be so happy together. Thank you.
Hi Molly and Tommy, thank you for making us both bridesmaids. It's been a wonderful day. We really appreciate everything you've done, and I hope you've enjoyed your day. Thank you so much.
We hope you have a good future together.
All the luck to the future. Love you.
Mrs. Ramsbottom, yes you are Mrs. Ramsbottom now, you fell for it, but we're here. Just a quick message to say how much I love you, you mean the absolute world to me. Absolutely stunning today, walking down the aisle you looked absolutely amazing. I'd be so proud to call you my wife for the future. Let's make it a good one, thank you very much.